we're at NAMM 2011 Anaheim. We're at the ESP booth.
And as you can see, it's f***ing rocking.
I was introduced to ESP when I was a teenager by bands like Anthrax and Loudness and Queensryche.
I've been with ESP for a long time, probably almost 3 decades.
I don't even know how many years it's been, but it's been a while. They're so easy to work with. They've always treated me great. The guitars are great too. I love playing their guitars.
It was a guitar that, to me, when I saw it, I was like, that's the one I gotta have. Now I know why I got it. It just feels great. I can't see playing another instrument.
You've got to check out the new Slayer Anniversary Guitar Man. 25 years of rain and blood. These guys deserve everything that's come their way. F-ing badass guitar. Right there.
I got to see it in the factory. I got to see the new Rain and Blood guitar. I think they only made about 300 of them or something like that.
The Rain and Blood guitar is, you know, any metal fan is gonna want to get that.
I love it, and I like the whole idea of the concept of it. I definitely play that guitar. It's basically my same guitar that I always use, but it's gonna be awesome.
I played the new Hetfield model. It's great. Surprisingly very light.
The new Metallica Explorer, that thing's pretty cool. I like that.
When I first got introduced to ESP was when the company was in New York. We were on the Metallica and Justice for All tour, and ESP gave us some ESP Mirages. Still have them today.
I've just been checking out all the new acoustic guitars for ESP, which I'm really excited about. I don't think they've ever done an acoustic guitar before.
This is awesome. Beautiful finish, beautiful tone, and I assume very affordable, which is a good thing, because, you know, when we're starting out, we need affordable guitars.
The acoustics are amazing. I haven't played an acoustic guitar for the value pretty much ever. The built-in tuner and all that stuff.
The LTD acoustic series that they just came out with, I have played with them. They seem very cool.
ESP stuff is top of the line anyway.
The X-Tone, I haven't electric version of the X-Tone. It's the first I've seen of the acoustic model. Looks really, really nice. Yeah, nice inlays, nice top here. Well, with Queensryche, we do a lot of acoustic, we do a lot of radio shows, so I hope I get one of these.
I'm very excited that they finally came out with them, because now I can have an acoustic guitar in my arsenal.
Yeah, I've just been basically playing the last few days, talking about the guitars and generally just kind of getting into the whole vibe of the NAMM show. I've never played here before and it's an awesome event.
I play the X-Tone PS1 semi-hollow body, kind of has that vintage look. I'm here at my first NAMM convention, so I always hear about it, but it's the first time that I've come here just to see the madness.
My name is Alo Carrillo. I'm a bass player. I play ESP basses, custom basses. Stopping by and saying hi to my friends at ESP. All this craziness, NAMM show, you know. Beautiful tone, beautiful construction, build, great for the road.
What makes ESP great is the stability in the necks. I use a maple neck and I travel all over the world. I put my guitar on airplanes in the luggage. You know, I wake up in Iraq or somewhere when the thing's in tune.